In demonology, Belphegor, or Beelphegor, is a demon, and one of the seven princes of hell, who helps people make discoveries. He seduces people by suggesting to them ingenious inventions that will make them rich. According to some 16th century demonologists, his power is stronger in April. Bishop and witch hunter Peter Binsfeld believed that Belphegor tempts by means of laziness. Also, according to Peter Binsfeld's classification of demons, Belphegor is the chief demon of the deadly sin, known as Sloth in Christian tradition. Belphegor originated as the Assyrian Baal-Peor, the Moabitish god to whom the Israelites became attached in Shittim, Numbers 25:3, which was associated with licentiousness and orgies. It was worshipped in the form of a phallus. As a demon, he is described in Kabbalistic writings as the disputer, an enemy of the sixth Sephiroth beauty. When summoned, he can grant riches, the power of discovery and ingenious invention. His role as a demon was to sow discord among men, and seduce them to evil through the apportionment of wealth. Belphegor, Lord of the Opening, was pictured in two different fashions, as a beautiful young woman or as a monstrous, bearded demon with horns and sharply pointed nails. The former form, according to most sources, was his earthly disguise when invoked by mortals. According to de Plancy's Dictionnaire Infernal, he was the Underworld's ambassador to France. Belphegor also figures in Milton's Paradise Lost, and in Victor Hugo's, The Toilers of the Sea. According to legend, Belphegor was sent from the underworld by Pluto to find out if there really was such a thing on Earth as married happiness. Rumor of such had reached the demons, but they knew that people were not designed to live in harmony. Belphegor's experiences in the world soon convinced him that the rumor was groundless. The story is found in various works of early modern literature, hence the use of the name to apply to a misanthrope or a licentious person. The name Belphegor is a corruption of the biblical name Baal-Peor, the god of the Moabites. Some rabbis claim that he must be worshipped on a toilet, with offerings being the residue of one's digestion. This has led some to conclude that Belphegor is the god Pet, Fart, or Crepitus, while others believe that he is Prepus. Selden is cited by Bainier as reporting that human victims are to be offered to him, and that his priests partake of the flesh. Warris wrote that he always has an open mouth, attributing it to the name Fager, which according to Leloir means crevice or split, and refers to when he was worshipped in caves and people threw him offerings through an air hole. Belphegor originated as the Assyrian Baal-Peor, the Moabitish god to whom the Israelites became attached in Shittim, Numbers 25:3, which was associated with licentiousness and orgies. It was worshipped in the form of a phallus. Numbers 25 describes that when Israel was in the northeast corner of the plains of Moab, called Abel Shittim, they had illicit relations with the Moabite women and sacrificed to their god. As punishment, Moses and all the other Israelites who had sacrificed to Baal-Peor were to be killed. This slaughter amounted to 24,000 deaths. Number 25:9. Several other passages seem to refer to the event. Your eyes have seen what the Lord has done in the case of Baal-Peor, for all the men who followed Baal-Peor, the Lord your God has destroyed them from among you. Deuteronomy 4:3. They joined themselves also to Baal-Peor, and ate sacrifices offered to the dead. Psalm 106:27-29. I found Israel like grapes in the wilderness, I saw your forefathers as the earliest fruit on the fig tree in its first season. But they came to Baal-Peor and devoted themselves to shame, and they became as detestable as that which they loved. Hosea 9:10. He may be identified with Chemosh, the Moabite war god who fought against the Israelites. Woe to you, Moab! The people of Chemosh have perished, for your sons have been taken away captive and your daughters into captivity. Jeremiah 48:46. He was sometimes depicted as a phallus, a cone, a pillar, or a tree branch. As male, he was the sun god. As female, a moon goddess sometimes associated with Ishtar. As Baal-Peor, he was androgynous. As Chemosh, he would have been worshipped by Solomon. Then Solomon built a high place for Chemosh, the detestable idol of Moab, on the mountain which is east of Jerusalem, and for Molech, the detestable idol of the sons of Ammon. 1 Kings 11:7. The high places which were before Jerusalem, which were on the right of the Mount of Destruction which Solomon, the king of Israel, had built for Ashtoreth, the abomination of the Sidonians, and for Chemosh, the abomination of Moab, and for Milcom, the abomination of the sons of Ammon, the king defiled. 2 Kings 23:13. According to legend, Belphegor was sent from the underworld by Lucifer to find out if there really was such a thing on earth as married happiness. Rumor of such had reached the demons, but they knew that people were not designed to live in harmony. Belphegor's experiences in the world soon convinced him that the rumor was groundless. The story is found in various works of early modern literature, hence the use of the name to apply to a misanthrope or a licentious person. While some of the scholars believe that he is not one of the seven princes, some say that he is one of them and not just a high-ranking one. Let me know what you think of this grand personality of purgatory in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Love, the Takik Studios.